I'm going to show you how to make something better than an antibiotic, something natural, something that is very, very low in toxicity, something that goes way beyond antibiotics, because antibiotics only address bacteria. They don't address yeast infections. They don't target parasites or viruses or fungus or mold. And I'm going to recommend taking this at the first sign of a sickness. Now, that could be a tickle in your throat. It could be fatigue. It could be when you're run down. Let's say you haven't slept and you feel tired and you know you probably are going to come down with something. And many of these infections start in the throat or the sinuses, and then they can spread to the lung. And so if you could prevent this from the very beginning, that would be a very, very good thing. Now, of course, check with your doctor before using a substitute for medication. And I want to bring up a very important point when you get sick, especially with a child, especially with a young adult. Getting sick is a normal thing, okay? Going through this whole immune reaction actually teaches your immune system how to fight better. And if you never got sick, you would never develop half of your immune system, because we are born with something called the innate immune system, which our mother gave us. And then we also have another immune system called the acquired immune system that we acquire by getting sick and being exposed to pathogens and becoming stronger. And so there's nothing really wrong about going through some type of sickness. But as you get older and you want to shorten the time of getting an infection or even preventing it from becoming a full-blown infection, there's some things you need to know about, and there's some things that you can take if you catch it in the very, very beginning. There seems to be a window right in the very beginning of an infection where if you can boost your immune system, okay, you can actually prevent going through this entire cycle of this immune reaction, which could last anywhere between 7 to 10 days or longer. And the big problem with a lot of people is as soon as they start getting sick, they run to the doctor and they start taking an antibiotic. And sometimes they don't know that antibiotics only deal with bacterial infections. They don't deal with viruses, fungal infections, or yeast infections. And then when the bad bacteria is killed, you also at the same time kill the good bacteria. And then you end up with a secondary infection. You end up with a weaker immune system. And then when you start it, those bacteria that you just killed actually keep certain yeast in check, okay? And so when you wipe those out, you end up with this overgrowth of some candida or yeast infections many of the time. So an ideal solution would not give you another problem. And of course, as we all know, the overuse of antibiotics has put us in a really bad place, because now we have strains of microbes that are very, very resilient to antibiotics. You can't kill them anymore. They're super strains. And unfortunately, 80% of antibiotics are given to animals, and then we eat the animals. And the whole thing just weakens our immune system. So we need a more effective solution. We need something that doesn't give us a bigger problem. We need a better strategy. Now, before I get into the remedy, I want to mention something about stress. There's always some stressor that occurs right before you get sick. There's something that lowers your immune system. What happens is you're activating the hormone cortisol. Cortisol actually suppresses the immune system, okay? And so this is why when you go through chronic stress, it suppresses your own ability to fight pathogens to invade the body. This is exactly why people with autoimmune diseases usually have this stress trigger, whether it's a loss of a loved one, or it's a loss of a job, or some stressor that shocks the system, jacks up cortisol, and then you start to have problems. So if we know that and we understand that, it's vitally important at the first sign of sickness to do whatever you can to reduce the stress. Go for a long walk outside in nature. Avoid the stress as much as possible. But it's important to know that there are certain things out there that lower the immune system. And if you don't address that, this remedy probably is not going to do much good. Now, this remedy revolves around certain plant extracts, okay? Certain plant extracts that have properties that are not only antibacterial, but they're antiviral, antifungal, antiparasitic. See, plants, as a part of their survival mechanism, have developed these highly sophisticated defense mechanisms that are actually quite amazing, because the problem with plants is they can't run away. So they're stuck in one spot. And so they're constantly invaded by bacteria, insects, fungus from the soil. So for eons, they have developed different strategies of survival. And so we can piggyback on those mechanisms and actually eat those plants to get those strategies in a natural form. But what's really cool is that when you consume these antimicrobial chemicals, it doesn't seem to harm our good bacteria. There's a very low toxicity effect. So it's really an ideal solution. Now, there's a couple things you might need for this this remedy. You'll need a garlic press, okay? You'll need a blender, and you'll need a mason jar with a good lid, about 16 ounces. Now, this remedy is a broad spectrum antimicrobial, okay, with low toxicity. There's going to be a basic a brew that you're going to make, but there's additional things you can add to make it even more amazing. And personally, I like to grow as much of this as possible to use my own plants in my garden. But if you don't have a garden, you can just buy these things either in the plant itself or the powder. So you're going to make up this brew. You're going to keep it in your mason jar in the refrigerator. Okay. And at the first sign of a sickness, whether it's a fatigue, a tickle in the throat, a coughing episode, or whatever, you're going to take two shots of this brew, okay, two little shot glasses, and you'll spread it out through the day. So you'll do one in the morning and one later on during the day. Now, some of these compounds are fat soluble, okay? So you need to add olive oil to this mixture to help break down some of these fat soluble compounds. So let's talk about the main base of this remedy here. It uses garlic, okay? It uses whole lemon. It uses apple cider vinegar and extra virgin olive oil. Okay, that's the main blend. Now, you can add a lot of other things to spice it up, but this is the basic formula. So you're going to take four garlic cloves, and you're going to put it through a little press. Okay, you're going to take the juice of this garlic right into the blender. Okay, then you're going to take a whole lemon, and you're going to put that into the blender. I would recommend it that it's organic, so there's no pesticides. There's a lot of amazing things in that lemon peel that are antimicrobial, not to mention a really good amount of vitamin C, okay, in the seeds and the lemon peel. Actually, it's more than the pulp. Next thing you're going to do is you're going to take 2 cups of apple cider vinegar, and you're going to pour that in the blender. And then you're going to take 1 ounce of olive oil, extra virgin, and put it in the blender. And you're going to blend this for like 1 minute. Okay? You're going to make it into this slurry. Now, you could very easily just keep it in this mason jar and put it in the refrigerator and use it as is. But what I like to do is I like to spice it up with some additional things to make it way more powerful. Okay. And you can do any one or more of these next items I'm going to mention, and you can get them in a powder or do what I do. I just take a little snip off the plant and I stick it in the blender. So this is what I use. I use some turmeric powder. Okay. Or you can just use a little piece of turmeric, but if you're going to use the powder, you can use like 2 tablespoons and put that in the blender. You're going to use some sage, okay? Sage is a very powerful antimicrobial. Use 1 teaspoon of sage powder, or you can just take a little clip off the sage plant, stick it in the blender. That's what I do. Then we're going to use thyme, okay? 1 teaspoon of thyme powder, or just take a little clip of the thyme plant, stick it in the blender. Then we're going to use rosemary, okay? You can use rosemary powder, 1 teaspoon, or a little snip off the rosemary plant, stick it in the blender. Okay, and then take about 6 cloves, stick it into the blender. Clove is a very strong antiviral, very strong anti-parasite, anti-worm. It kills a lot of things. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little red radish, okay? Stick that in the blender too. Radish is very, very high in sulfur compounds that are very antimicrobial. And radish is also anti-mucus. So it's going to help pull mucus out of the body. And then lastly, we're going to take half of a small onion, and stick that in as well. So I'm going to blend all this up very nicely, maybe, I don't know, 1 to 1.5 minutes. And then I'm going to pour everything into this mason jar, a 16-ounce mason jar. And that is my brew that I will keep in the refrigerator. And over time, it will also ferment. So it's going to actually be more powerful over time, but you can use it at any time. So during certain winter months when you don't get enough sun, during stress periods, or at the first sign of a sickness, take a shot of this, okay? It doesn't taste very good, okay? I'm going to just tell you in advance, it tastes terrible, okay? But it will kill the microbes and it won't kill the good bacteria. And then you're going to wait several hours and you're going to do another shot. Now, let's say, for example, you miss this window of opportunity to head off this infection. And now you're in it, okay? You're in this full infection. What I would recommend to do is I would recommend to drink 4 to 6 shots of this brew every single day. What that's going to do, it's going to shorten your time of infection, okay, and minimize the intensity of the infection and get you through this infection a lot faster. And the other thing I want to mention is a lot of these ingredients could just be consumed in your foods on a regular basis to keep your immune system very strong. Now, I think it's very appropriate right now for you to learn more about the immune system. And I have a very specific video on this topic. Check it out.